Hello everyone. As a part of VTV Sikshana program, this is a continuation of module number 1 of Computer Networks and Security subject. In the previous session, we have discussed about two important protocols of application layer. One is HTTP protocol and one is FTP protocol. And along with that, we'll discuss and summarize the differences and similarities between those two protocols. Okay, so in this session, we are going to deal with very important concept of application layer called as email, or we can also call it as electronic mail. How electronic mail works, how the mail will be transferred from sender queue to receiver queue, and what are the different protocols required to transfer the mail, and other details in this session. Okay, without wasting the time, well, let me deal with the important aspects of very important mechanism which we all depend upon. Okay, it might be some of the email applications, like it might be Gmail, it might be Yahoo, it might be any email, Hotmail or whatever. Okay, but the mechanism beyond that will retain the same. Okay, the three major important components that are required for email are: one is user agent, mail servers, and very important protocol called as SMTP protocol. SMTP is nothing but simple mail transfer protocol, within which we are going to have two more protocols. I'll deal with those two protocols later. Before going for the complete aspect of how this electronic mail works, let me give you the brief analogy for this. I have a mail, classical postal mail. Okay, what I require to do the classical postal mail, I'm going to write a detail later with the help of pen. I'm going to write it. And I am going to write the two orders to where I want to send. Correct? No? After writing the complete mail, let me consider like this. After writing this, I'll write the two orders and I'll write the from address. Correct? No? And I'll cover this because nobody should open this. So I'll cover with the help of some glue and I'll put it in the post box. Correct? No? I'll put it in the post box. What the next job? The postman. Who is a person who is going to act like an intermediate person between the sender and receiver. He will take all the post mails which are present in the post box and he'll put all the things in this bag and he'll take over to the respective destination. Okay, kindly remember this analogy. It is very simple to understand the working of email in a similar fashion. Okay, so in the similar fashion, if you want to operate any email, if you want to call any electronic mail, the operations retains the same. Okay, let me have the email system will be having these things. One is user agent who is going to send the data to somebody else, and that will be delivered to, let me consider this user agent as sender and this user agent as receiver. Okay, even though it is it might be the receiver here. Okay, even though it is, it might be these may act like senders or these may act like receiver, whatever. Okay, so each and every mailbox, each and every user agent is attached with mail servers. Remember this. Okay, for example, you can remember in this way. If I'm going to write a letter, I should put that post in the post box. Correct? No? So there should be a post box nearby. Okay, for example, there is an area. Okay, let me call the areas Vijayanagar. Okay, all the people who are going to write the letters in their respective places, they have to put all the mailbox to nearest post office or post box. Correct? No? Similarly, the user agent, they are present in the network. If they want to send the mail, they have to send the mail with the help of mail servers. We can call them as what? Mail servers. The mail servers indirectly have a very important data structure called as queue. Okay, message queue, commonly called them as message queue. Okay, why we require the message queue? Because I may have different users. They have embedded all the post mails to their respective servers, but the mail server has to do the operation in hierarchy. Correct? No? They cannot able to deliver all the post mails in a single iteration. Which post has to be delivered first, which mail has to be delivered next, that should be decided by a very important data structure called as queue, message queue. Okay, so let me consider an example. There is a sender and there is a receiver. Okay, I want to send a mail from here to here. What the sender will does, he will open the application layer protocol called http://www.anexample.gmail.com. Once you open that, he will be logged into the user authentication phase. He has to enter the username. He has to enter the valid password. If they are fine, they will go into their respective homepage. They have to press a button called as compose button. Okay. And he has to write the data, which whatever he want to send, and he has to give the sender address. By default, it will be there, and he has to mention the very important address called as receiver address. We can call it as to where I want to send the data. Correct? No? And that mail will be present in the very important queue called as outbox queue, or we can call it as user outbox. Correct? No? So what the queue will does, he will take the first mail and he will deliver the data to the first respective destination. Okay, and he will take the second mail and deliver to the second respective destination. Okay, if the receiver also wants to receive the data, this is the mail, what the receiver has to do? Receiver has to have an queue, and that queue is called as inbox queue. Okay, commonly we can call combine that as user mailbox. Okay, it might be inbox or it might be outbox. Okay, and they will be having a separate storage for that to store the data, and that will be popped up immediately. Those are new mails. Okay, these are the three important entities we have. One is user agent, one is mail server, and one more is, if we have a communication between one mail server with the other mail server, and that can be happened only with the help of one important protocol called as SMTP protocol. Called as simple mail transfer protocol. It might be of any company application. It might be Gmail, Yahoo, Hotmail, or Yahoo, whatever it might be. They have to go over this mechanism with the help of a protocol called SMTP protocol. Okay. What the meaning of SMTP? Simple mail transfer protocol. Okay. And we all know that the SMTP also works with the help of underlying protocol. We all know about TCP protocol called as reliable protocol, and with a port number 25. Okay. Which port number it will use? It will use a port number called 25. Okay. Can it use from where to where the port number can be used? The port numbers are the unique numbers that will be assigned by the machine for the hardware communication between the sender to destination. Port numbers will be always having a size from 1 to 1024, and these are the default port numbers. They are already assigned to different protocols, like HTTP having a port number as 80, and FTP they are having a port numbers like 21 and 23 and so on. Okay, if I want to use one port number for my own communication, I have to use the port numbers above 1024. If you use within the 1024 port number, it will give an error message as this port number is already used by the default protocols. Okay, until the, what is the maximum port number we can use? We can use up to 65,535. Okay, so this is the maximum port number we can use, that is 2/32. Okay, this is what one important thing you have to remember. And here also I am going to use TCP as a reliable protocol of transport layer as HTTP users, and with the port number 25. Okay, and we all know about TCP. TCP mainly works with the help of three important stages: handshaking, transfer of messages, and closure. Hence, TCP is called as a reliable protocol. Why reliable? Whatever the packets I'm going to send from sender to destination, that will get an acknowledgement for that. For each and every byte of data, the data is going to be delivered from sender to receiver, all the data will be having the acknowledgement. Okay. So if any packet lost in the network, that will be immediately indicated to the sender. So we will be not having much packet loss in case of TCP protocol. Okay. But in case of UDP, it's not like that. They won't bother about sender or they won't bother about receiver. They will simply bombard the data. Correct? No? They are same as of their politicians. Okay, they won't check out whether the receiver is listening or not. Simply they deliver the data. But in case of TCP, it's not like politicians. I can give an analogy like a person who introduce himself to a receiver and then he'll share the data. Okay, so that is the meaning of handshaking. And then after greeting themselves, they'll transfer the data. After sending all the data, we'll say bye, no, we'll go bye and on. That's called as closure. TCP also works in these three important phases. Okay, and SMTP protocol and this, you know, will have a defined port number, a defined RFC number called A2821. Okay, I think I had mentioned the detailed aspects of RFC in your previous session already. Okay, and to know about different commands and interaction, SMTP also uses different ASCII codes as we had used in HTTP and FTP. As we, in case of FTP, we have HTTP, we have GET method, POST method, and all those other commands. And similarly, FTP, we have SEND, RECEIVE, and all, right? RECEIVE and all in the same way. Here also we have commands. Okay, and all the command messages will be having the ASCII value of 7-bit ASCII value. Okay, these are some of the features of SMTP protocol. Which are the features? SMTP also works with a reliable protocol called TCP with a port number 25. TCP will always have three phases of operation. One is handshaking, transfer of message, and closure. And similarly, as of FTP and HTTP, it also uses command language. Okay. And now, let me look up some scenario how this, you know, email works with the help of one mail box to other mailbox. Okay, how this works, how this happens. Let me consider Ali's agent, she's the sender here, and Bob's agent, this is the receiver. If Ali's want to send a data, she has to use his computer, we can call it as an agent. With the help of her computer, she can send a mail with the help of her mail server. Okay, and obviously it has to underwent an important protocol called SMTP protocol, and the communication between one mail server with other mail server will be happened with the help of SMTP protocol, as I said already. And once the data reaches the mail server of the Bob will take out the data which it wants to deliver, and that will be taken to the Bob's respective agent, that will be popped up in his mailbox. It is a simple scenario. Okay, simple scenario. How the command language can be implemented for this interaction between Alice and Bob? We'll see that now. Okay, Alice uses user agent to compose mail to Bob at some address. Correct? No? What Alice require? Alice require user address. Who is the receiver here? Bob. So what is the Bob address? This is the Bob address. Okay. Ali's user agent send message to her mail server, and message placed in a message queue. I think we can check out here. Whatever the message the Ali's wanted to send, that will be placed in the mail server of Ali's with respect to the two address. What is the two address here? Bob's address. Along with the Bob address and the mail server, with the help of the queue, it will transfer the data to the destination. Okay. Client side of SMTP opens a very important connection. Whenever it wants to send a data, instead of telling it as SMTP protocol, a TCP connection has been established between Ali's mail server with Bob mail server. A TCP connection has been established. Okay. What is the port number for that? The port number is 25. Okay. So, SMTP client sends Ali's message over the Bob TCP connection, and Bob mail server places the message to Bob's mailbox. Okay, and whenever Bob's opens his system, opens his mailbox, he will be popped up with the new mail which has been received by the Bob's mail server. Okay, this is the overall interaction that is going to happen between Alice and Bob. Okay, so we can have the same interaction here. User agent 1, 2, 3 operation, fourth operation that happened between the mail server, fifth operation that is placed in the mail server of the receiver, and sixth operation of the receiver user agent. Let me see this, how this interaction will happen, how the operation is going to happen in the next session. Okay, what are the commands that's going to use? What is the status code that's going to use between the commands? How many interactions required? How user agent sends the data to the server? And all the other details in the next session with an example. I hope so you got some knowledge on email, how email works with the help of three important agents, mail server, user agent, and SMTP protocol. SMTP protocol will be have to have a communication between one mail server with the other mail server. Okay, so we'll see with the example of how email works in your next session. Thank you so much.